push that on.
No, they're inside.
Are you doing them?
Yes.
Turn it on yet?
Start talking.
G'day, we're here today with Mitch Portlock, the coach of... G'day, we're here today with the coach of Western Island, Mitch Portlock. Big game today, Mitch. How are you guys going to win it?
Oh, good to be here, Craig. We'll, well, I think we play a pretty similar way every week, so we'll try to run, limit our kicking, especially into that forward area, just so that we're not creating too many turnovers and allowing their loose, which is Andy Crate generally, that to peel off and intercept our balls and defend aggressively, hold our shape, and hopefully we're able to put a few over the bar to be in front at the end.
I see Brad Haskett's a big in for this week. What's he going to give to the side?
He's going to come off the bench, but what you've seen him before. He's big and powerful. He's a good forward for Jake and Joel, which will give us three guys around that 6'5 mark that are really agile. So hopefully at times we have all of them out there, which might be able to stretch their size. They get a couple of good bigs, but not many teams have three guys as big and agile as those guys. So Brad's going to be a nice in. He hasn't played too much Gaelic this year, but he's been here and he's really keen. So.
Excellent. I also see Harry's recovered from his toe injury. Is he going to start forward or back?
He's going to start off as well. So Harry's toe injury is fine. He actually played 2 weeks ago, but he's okay. It was just cutting a nerve out of his toe, which is fine. But he's very versatile. He'll probably give Joel a break. He'll probably have to run around with Jamie at times, and hopefully he's able to contribute when he gets out there.
Excellent. Also, I've really enjoyed this year watching young Cheese Platter down in the back half playing. Brings a bit of rebound and run and carry. What's his improvement down to?
Well, he's super fit now. So, and I think he may have quietened on the circuit a little bit. So he used to indulge in a little bit of Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday action most weeks. But he's got his running times now. He's doing under 7 minute 2Ks and he's looking fit. But he's 21, 22 now. You come of age, you start to learn what the game is, and he's certainly reading it well, and he runs really hard. So his fitness will be really important. He'll probably mind Aiden Coakley today, and I think he'll put him under some pressure. Aiden's a very, very good player, but if Cheese can be somewhere near him, at least that'll limit Aiden's ability to beat us.
I think that's a great matchup. That's going to be a good one to watch, probably for everyone. Just want to say good luck, and hopefully Captain Macca's hands don't get swallowed by someone's bigger.
That'll definitely happen, mate. Thanks, Greg.
Cheers, Mitch.
Hello, hello, it is, yep, got me, perfect, beautiful.
We're all over this.
Now, welcome again to the other side of the coin. On this side, we have Jamie, the captain of Onkers. Congratulations for making the GF, mate. Good to be here, obviously, on today, but yeah. Talk us through how you think you're going to get over the top of Western.
Well, every year we've had a bit of a struggle against Western in the finals. We've probably gone into a few of our games with a kick-in game style, but the way Western plays, they flood players back. And we've kind of played into their hands the last few years. So this year we're thinking of running it up, moving the ball a bit quicker and seeing if we can catch them before they can flood the defence.
Nice. You had some tough games in the lead-up, so it's not like you're walking into this just easy straight into a GF. So do you think those games previously might help you going forward into this week?
Yeah, definitely. The last few years we've missed out on the prelim final, so we've gone straight into the grand final. And this year, just that extra game, extra run on the legs, bit of confidence with the lads has really helped us.
Yeah, your game style has definitely improved over the second half of the year. And I do think if you've got a game style than the old Onkers, that this will be a very competitive
That's
game.
Right.
Let's go personally now. The body, you've been out for most of the year. So obviously with you coming back in, you're feeling okay, mate?
Yeah, feeling good. It's good to be back. I probably gave myself an extra couple of games than I needed on the bench, just to be sure I would be ready for the finals. And fair juice to the lads as well, being able to pull us through, get us into the finals, because it wasn't an easy season. We had a few injuries and Yeah, fair juice to the lads.
Yep, definitely. Now you've definitely the top two teams of the comp. Look, Flinders played obviously pretty well, and obviously our team came up and gave them a bit. But at the same time, best two teams always seem to rise to the top when needed. And this year, it's definitely you two. So good luck, and hopefully you're holding the cup up at the end.
Thank you very much, Noobs.
Cheers. Good luck, bud.
Pardon? No.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good afternoon and welcome to our grand final for the men's State League Gaelic competition for the year. My name is Christian Neeson. I'm the Vice President of the Gaelic Football and Hurling Association of South Australia. Before we get things going, I would like to perform a welcome to country. The Gaelic Football and Hurling Association of South Australia acknowledges this land and the traditional lands of the Kaurna people, and that we respect their spiritual relationship with their country. We also acknowledge the Kaurna people as the custodians of the Adelaide region, and that the cultural and heritage beliefs are still as important to the living Kaurna people today. On a sad note, we'll have a respectful minute silence for the passing of Jeff Elson. So condolences to Paul and Roz and the entire Elson family. We'll start that minute silence now. Thank you. To the Elson family. We'll now go into the anthem of Ireland.
Karen.
Forgot to pay Spotify.
Thank you, and now we'll have the Australian national anthem. Thank you. Good luck to both teams and today's referee, Stephen Clay.
A roaming Ben.
So what's your thought process on the yellow boots? Harry Burdett.
And welcome today to the Gaelic Football and Hurling Association of South Australia's grand final for 2020 and 2021. Today here at St Mary's Park, Western Island versus Onkaparinga. Good afternoon if you're tuning in from Adelaide, or good morning, 6 a.m. over in Ireland in the homeland. So thanks for tuning in, and you've got Ben Newbury here and Craig Bevan on the commentary today. Welcome, Craig.
G'day, Ben. G'day to listeners, watchers, everyone out there. I reckon we're in for a humdinger.
I really do too. These definitely are the best two sides of the comp this year. And with the strength now of a couple of returning guys from injury, like Wado and our man Jamie, Onkers are definitely looking like they're the real deal this year. What about you, Craig? What do you think? How do you think this will play out?
Bevo thinks that the winner here today is going to be Western Island. I think their depth is just a little stronger than Onkers, so it'll be a very interesting game. I think it's going to be tight. Whoever can break open early, and we're away.
And the big fella has got the ball forward, being old Jakey, and now they've quickly turned it over. Just that quick turnover in a grand final can always happen. Just to settle the nerves, the boys will be trying to knock one down. Good old Jack just doing the settler now, just getting a few touches early. Oh, there's a tough tackle there, and a turnover.
Oh, reckon there was a chopping of arm early, but the milk crate kicks it forward. We've got Paulie. Oh, is he going to take it or what? Let it run? Oh, he's tried to let it run. I reckon it's come off his foot. Oh, I reckon you've made a blue there, Matthew. I reckon that's come off the foot of the Western player there. He's come back into Little Hands Macca, who has dropped it. If you've seen the size of his hands, it's going to be pretty hard for him to catch the ball all day.
They're only just a little bit smaller than yours, though, Craig. So, hey, all good.
Still nah, smaller.
Right now, we're having a little battle down in the back corner for Western Island. They'll not be able to break it clear, but a bit of composure from Macca just to get it forward. Bit of heat on early, which is good. So now they've turned it over, and just gone out of bounds. Maddie's all over that out and that outer wing. Good on you. So she's a nice day here at St Mary's. Not really a breath of wind. Mitchy Portlock getting now an early touch. Trying to push it forward. Now he's again with a bit of composure. Throws it down in the middle. They like to break lines and own the middle corridor, Western Island. And pushing forward there was old Paul Elson. And now Jackie pushing forward again. No doubt he'll try and turn inside out Jamie. So, dishes off. There's now attempt at goal and going wide. Well left there by Dom. Brother of Jamie.
Son of Tony, as he's now going to come out. Notorious long kicker is Dom. He can really kick a long ball. I know last week against the mighty Taints, they used his kick out really effectively to their big guys, Stocky, Jamie, as he goes long.
And Leroy, looks like Leroy's got this one. Nice little play on. And
Tommy. Yeah. Tommy puts the ball in.
Pushes it in.
Maisie. Here's the first opportunity.
Oh, and an onion. There's the onion. First of the day. First score is a sack.
Had Lewis in all sorts down there as a goalkeeper. Really good ball movement by Onkers.
It was, wasn't it? It's that's what we pretty much just said. The kickouts have improved over the latter part of the year, and really looking for players and playing on quickly.
Oh,
Western Island have definitely started a bit. Bit nervous. They're turning the footy over. Onkers are a bit more composed. Pushing forward again. Old Mazo.
Onkers were really good last week around here. They were putting up some shots and they just couldn't miss. Tommy sets them up really well.
Just a centering ball.
And we've got Salmonella Mitch. Nice catch. Comes back in. Flicks it off the Stocky. Oh, what a save. Well done.
Nearly another Sakaruni.
And a 45. Game's been hot early, noobs.
It has. Yeah, Western really haven't settled. I get the feeling at the moment. The boys from Onkers just feeling the pressure a little bit. Got now the first score of the game and looking a little bit more settled in this grand final.
And again, last week against the Taints, young Lee here, he was fantastic on his kicks off the ground.
Well played. Well played. He certainly was. And welcome, everyone. Over in Victoria too, there's a couple of young lads over there tuning in.
Just missed the early one. We have a quick look at the TK print scoreboard, and we've got
the score upside down, wrong way round. Onkers should be one goal to zero.
But at the moment, the Onkers have got one.
Chris Goodness. Andy Groom's taking the catch there, and he plays on, kicks it long down the line. He's got Elliot swings back in. He flicks it off to Jack Andrews, who's a special player. He's just going to flick it on again, and Andy Crate gets in the way and trips over. Class of Jamie's just going to shore this up. What's going on there? Oh, a couple of pushes, and Raisin Toasty has finally got onto it.
Always likes to involve himself in the game, young Toasty, as they push wide through to Joel. Oh, no, that wasn't Joel. My bad. That was Dylan. Old Dylan in the middle. So Jamie now just sends it back inside.
It was Clunny done a hammy. No, he's all right. Sorry, a little overreaction there. He's put on a few kilos since I played under eights against Clunny in 1988. Jamie to Carrot. Carrot flicks the ball out wide. We've got Leroy Marsh. This could be a turnover. That's one of Leroy's specialties. Good hit by Chris Groom. What are we going to pay here? He's played it on. He's letting the game play. He's raising toast.
That's what you want in a grand final.
Yeah, let the boys settle.
That's it.
Tommy's a class act. I really like watching Tommy play. And that's holding the footy umpire. Sorry, wrong game. Yeah, definitely a free kick.
And this is, I think, where Onkers normally shore themselves up. They've got a few options here on their ground ball for this free kick one, where Mitchie is a really solid kick off the deck.
Mitchie Salmoninella.
He's quite fantastic, to be honest. Oh, there's a centering ball. It's hot.
Oh, big take by Jamie.
Oh, and has he got it turned around left enough? No, still in play. And still live. Well done, Mitchie. Yep, nice there.
From Paulie Elson. Back half through Les Burdett now. Not sure if he's been to Burdett Hall recently, but it's a beautiful place. Get there. Flicks it on to Herman Munster. Coming down the outside now. Leroy's trying to shut him down. Bit of strength shown. Big fella comes back in board. That's lovely. Who's he got to go? He comes back. Clunny again. The keg. Les Burdett's pushed on. Got himself deep in a pocket. Back to Clunny.
Set him up.
What are they going to do here? It's some good ball movement. Back to Les Burdett.
Got nothing inside, though. They haven't run.
Yeah,
haven't run for them. They've got
giving
numbers
well
back
done,
now.
Leroy Marsh.
Definitely pushing numbers back. So now on the turnover, you've got Onkers pushing. Leroy's now nearly forgot where he was. Decided just to hang and hover. Lado's definitely settling. Trying to get now his numbers to push forward.
One of the champions of the competition, Lado. Played for many years and just a touch of class.
And a good bloke, too, to be honest. Doesn't mind a good old Frosty at the
end. Look at that, Brad Haskett, 3 games in thongs he's played to qualify, but here he is with boots. They look brand new, they're shining, nice and black.
They're not quite as shiny as others that are out there. Have you noticed the big shiny ones from the big Hasdog?
Harry Deruta.
They're nearly blinding me from over on the boundary right now.
He'd want to show some
Come
class.
Inside anyway now, it's a good ball inside. He's turned it over, and that would be Daniel. Good old Nully. He's got
first,
a little point.
First point for Western. Scoreboard's still incorrect.
Yep.
Wonder if someone's going to put that point up.
Now the old Dom just taking his time.
You don't see errors like that at TK Print.
I see now, Dom, it's normally the breeze heads to the left of screen.
Dom's thinning on top quite a bit too. I hadn't realised that earlier.
That's the Conlon curse, I think. Good competition here forward. Yeah, breaking ball here. Nice little crumb there by Tommy.
Started really well, Tommy.
He has, hasn't he? Just settling.
I think that's the first time we've called Coach.
It is.
He's going to want to work himself into the game.
And Mitchie's had a few. Oh, he's spun his own shadow there.
Out of the carrot. Well. And the ball.
There's a ball. Oh, no, spills out. Off to Demper.
Look at that. Gets
there
himself
it is.
Into the game.
The class. Oh, yeah, he's showing a bit of love. Yep. He doesn't mind a little sausage roll. He's just got the celly. Got that first little handball inside just to calm the nerves. It took him a while to get a touch. It'll be about 7 or 8 minutes in now, wouldn't it?
So we've got Matthew touching up the scoreboard. I think he might have the TK Print scoreboard
back up
and correct.
Got it correct. Yibbity-yibbity. Happy with that, folks. We've got another Floriani just floating down.
The young Flo, the one with some hair, the only one left.
Well, they all look about 45, though. I mean, this is coming from me, which is a bit steep, but anyway.
I think John is 45.
They all look 45.
Yeah, how good's Les Burdett's run?
He's looking smooth.
Turns
and then
it over.
Yeah,
he's
that's
come
all right.
Back, no advantage.
No advantage there.
Oh, yeah. A bit of a mouthful from Milk Crate there, I reckon.
Yeah, pretty even game early. I think Western have definitely now settled. The game style of Onkers pushing back is definitely hurting him because they don't have that cut inside and that option when they're running wide. They don't have that one flowing through the middle just to be able to give that bit of polish.
Mitch has just given him a roast too, Mitch Portlock. He's really let him have what he thinks. Never short of a word, Mitch.
Talking about boys that are carrying a few, is this that?
I thought he'd lost a bit.
Oh, okay, sure.
And it's gone wide. Jack Andrews would be disappointed with that.
He probably has across the season, that's a bit fair.
And
yeah.
Nully out the other side's kicked it on. I feel like he's trying to waste some time here, but there's a second ball, mate. Don't worry about it. Dom again, going to kick out from goals.
They're setting up.
We'll not go short.
There's a couple of free ones out there. Well, that's a bit slack from Western. That really is. He's got the arms up.
15 seconds. It's played on. Long down the line. Cokes again. Tell you, after we gave him a roasting, he's come back into it. He's gone back to leg tap. He's kicked on to Salmonella. Just slow plays.
There's a chip inside. Back in the Have a look at that from Mitchy. He's settled them. Definitely has. Oh, how did Carrot get through that?
And he's...
Oh, he tried to call his own free. That's interesting because he lost his boot. And now he's, we'll put that on and think he'll do that again a bit differently. Oh, Macca with his interesting little solo up the wing there.
He's probably got little feet like his little hands, I'd imagine.
Yeah, well, as he said, imagine trying to play this game with those size hands. It's impressive. It is impressive. Chips back inside to the old Mitch, just always in the play.
Yeah.
Never far away.
Hard man to slow down, the big fella. Just smooth mover. And on comes Harry for his first run with his yellow boots.
Yeah, straight
out to Jack Noonan, another one who used to be a really good running midfielder who now is probably a little slow.
Well, there's a couple of good... Oh, that's a solid hit there by Jamie. Yeah. I thought it was in the side, but hey, Toasty thought different and he's the ref.
I didn't mind that.
Bit of body work early.
Silver fox thinning Jamie.
Oh, it's the Colin curse, mate. It's okay. Some of us just have it.
Just had an update from Tony on the free kick count. It's been 1,000 to Western Island and 0 to Onkers. But I'm sure that'll even up over the game.
Is this going to be a settling kick there? A good old Ant. Just a bit wide. So... Now, they're all just trying to act big. They're zoning out here, Weston. They're not going man on man, which is an interesting move.
Hit him on the last kick out.
So
seems to have slowed him up, this one.
Oh, nice little chip inside.
Is that him up? No, he hasn't put it up. Too slow, yeah.
Nah, well reffed. Well done. That was far from in the air. Now they've got the run back. Are they going to wait like they've been doing lately and just hold up?
I like
their midfields come down.
Dylan Miller.
The old mullet.
Only 16-year-old. 16-year-old from Morphett Vale.
There's a few Morphett Vale boys that play this game, isn't there,
yeah,
Craig?
Yeah, Tates have got a few. Yeah. Mighty Tates.
Mighty and, Tates.
There's three or four out here too. Leroy Marsh, Morphett Vale, I think. So we've got Salmonella again, having another kick. Good old Mitch. Told me a story one day about Salmonella poisoning, how it came from the bears in Canada.
It is true. Look out for those drop bears in Canada as well. And all that's a pretty average kick from him.
Very ordinary. Oh,
you know what? He's got the commentator's curse. Give the guy a rap and look what bloody happens. Thanks, Mitch. Put that one down, eh? So, Lewis, to reset the Western, the Goats.
Well, I must admit, I enjoy how Western sing their song after every win through the season.
Yeah, it is a bit different.
The only team that do it and really rub it in to say Irish Australians who are three short, yet they play full 15 on 15.
Oh, each there's the Carrot. It's got the best mow out here, definitely by far, the old Carrot.
Yes. I feel like he's channeled Anchorman and Ron Burgundy.
Oh, that's definite Ron Burgundy style. Oh, Tommy.
Tommy again.
Tommy's again. And Wado, just to take it forward. Just a little chip to the mace. Gee, he's got a bit of leg power, the old big fella. Oh, and he's knocked him over. Bang. Anyway, turns over the footy.
Jack Andrews has worked back a long way.
Yeah, they sort of need to get a bit of composure here. And Jackie's working forward. Is he going to hit him up forward? Yes, he is.
Oh, Mitch.
Oh, that's a little bit wide. It's unlike Mitch, very uncharacteristic. Maybe he's feeling a bit of the pinch, this heat that Onkers have applied.
No emotion shown by Mitch either.
Oh, it rarely happens until after a game. He does his good work after dark.
Yeah. Could you imagine the roasting he would have given if that was someone else putting it out there?
Well, the boys are playing a good quality game of Gaelic footy here.
Oh, I'm sure that was 13, ref.
Oh, that's play on, though. He hasn't got his measuring tape handy.
Coakes has really worked into the game.
Yeah, he has.
Out the salmonella again. Back into Coakes. Fix it back out to leg tap.
Oh, that's Shepherd. That's old Shep. Over to Ron Burgundy.
Yeah, Shep wasn't even on the team sheet earlier. Lucky that we picked that up and sticks that up for Onkers. Jamie,
that's right.
Class act, Jamie.
Oh, that was a bit of a turnover.
Sorry, Jamie. Oh. I feel that was my error.
Commentary curse again. Strikes again.
Yeah. And Jackie Andrews, refs a bit. Won the sevens player of the year as a goalkeeper, and I didn't see him play there, but that's okay. Jack Noon on the outer wing. Gives it in to Harry DeRuda.
There's his first touch of the day. I think they're getting his boots a bit dirty.
I feel like that's...
Yeah, it was a bit after the play. So, I wouldn't mind you catching up with the play a bit further, though. That's just a bit of feedback early. Just, get involved, mate.
Come on, make sure you see it. Jackie Noon's
that's
inside.
A bad turnover straight to Marsh. Inside. Nah.
Leroy Marsh has absolutely played well. Ooh. He's done the opposite to the
But then, again, the commentator curse. He's just coughed it up and left Crady just waiting for his milk crate. Oh, and he's turned it over again. Ooh. Oh, dear.
Leroy Munster, that's come off. Just want to say good day to all the families out there. I know my young fella Job's watching, and he's just sent me a message, asked for a mention. So there it is, young fella.
I wonder if the Newbury family has got in there. Nah, they're silent. They're probably just playing down the beach. Anyway, that's enough about us. Oh, that's a solid
Adam
hit.
Floriani. Oh. That's the first time I've seen a Floriani not flinch and actually hit someone.
That was a solid effort. Maybe you didn't actually see him coming, but that's okay.
I'm looking forward to seeing the reflector John Flo come on. Wonder if he'll take the hat off when he takes the field.
Wonder if Toasty's going to get the snag and wagon at halftime cranking. Is that what he's going to fry up? I haven't actually seen it. I'm looking for a bit of a...
He is good on the sausage. He's our raisin toast.
Well, what do we got here? Who's lining up? Oh, so Mitchie failed on his last, so Jamie's gone, give it over to me because I'll get this done. He's a very confident young man and pops it up and pops it. Pops it over the bar.
Good score, Jamie. Feel like Newbs has got a man crush on Jamie.
Oh, who doesn't? So Lewis just setting up again. Oh, Harry, you're a bit early there, son. You need to be an option, but anyway.
A couple of good tips Harry's given me on the races this year, so I can't be too hard on him.
Yeah. Oh, nice
good
hit,
mark.
Leroy.
Play on.
I need to get it moving forward. Nice little smooth moving there from Mitch.
Oh, how's the shake and bake? And then the fumble.
Yep.
Oh, you don't see that too often.
That was nice defending. The numbers there for Onkers are quite good. The old Shepherd doesn't mind a song, I feel it.
Oh, stand him up, Macca.
Just committed, over-committed. Didn't stand him, you're right there. And Tommy, does he make him pay? He certainly does.
That's a good finish from Tommy.
Oh,
certainly one thing they did well last week was put their points over. And
surely his family back home are streaming in today. They'll be cheering away. There's a couple of claps for sure.
Yep.
Oh, just a quick little play on there.
The cheese platter, who has the filthiest mo I've seen out there today. As Mitch said earlier, he's doing the 2K and down to 7 minutes now, so he's got some fitness.
It's really taken a long time to make it down there.
Yeah, just a canter.
Now Clunny getting himself back. Oh no, that wasn't Clunny. That was his half brother.
I can tell you, I've got number 12 as Leigh Ryswyk for Western, but it's certainly not Leigh.
Jackie,
they are missing Leigh today. Couple of big outs in Will Rivers, the captain of Brighton Bombers for Div 1, amateur football, and Leigh Ryswyk, league footballer in the SANFL.
The Rizzo definitely makes him a better outfit, but that's all right. He's over in Queensland, I think, with the family.
Yes.
After doing his hamstring a couple of weeks ago.
I believe they've both done hamstrings. Want to get on the fitness and conditioning coach. No Daniel Boobris out there.
Oh, Ron Burgundy, what are you doing? Yep, there it is. Hands it off.
Here we go.
The smooth mooning Coakley. No.
Is Wade playing off half-back news?
Yeah, it looks like
he's
it.
He's certainly sweeping that role, and he's always been a forward, and he's doing a wonderful job.
There's a nice turnover in there by young Nullet. No, that was Kern. the Koenig. Over to Jack Hall. That's got to be a free. There's a plan on Varnage.
How long do we go? Ant. Surely Ant's a shoe-in for the team of the year this year. He's had a great season.
Oh, and there's a tackle from behind. Oh, play on. Oh, no, that was there. It was definitely a tackle from behind. Come on, boys.
I didn't think it was too bad, but certainly the Western Islands Noli really looked like a zombie out there.
Yes, it definitely can creep up on you. Now, is this going to be a settling kick? Settling over. Yeah, it lines up. And she goes wide. Yes.
I believe he's a neighbour of the great Todd Steele. Good chef, good footballer. Oh. Wollonga legend.
Absolutely. Catch up with him tomorrow, actually.
Excellent.
I'll pass on your regards.
Thank you. Dom again. Goes long.
Stocky. Big Harry.
Oh. I'll tell you, Stocky's been well covered today.
Yeah,
Onkers are doing a good job without him. But he was very impressive last week against the Taints. Anyone looking for a game next year and with some ability? Don't forget St. Brendan's.
Push him forward. Mitchie are getting their big guns come into it now. And push forward again. Is that Robbie? Yeah,
no, Nolly.
Oh, is it Nolly?
Yeah.
Oh,
his ambitions outweighed reality.
Herman number two there.
Back into Robbie.
Old Whittlesey, the old wit. Good defending there.
Oh,
Leroy.
Is that a ground ball?
Oh, yes.
Yes, raising toast hot on that one.
Yeah, Leroy. Talk about ambitions. Yeah, it just lines up. We've actually got a good view of this. Sitting right behind that. Oh, he centred the ball, I think. Or was it a good old Newbury shank?
See how we go. I'm not sure it was that bad. I wonder if Joel Whittlesey is any relation to the great Greg Whittlesey from the Sturt Football Club.
Oh, surely. So now, old Dom.
As his friends commonly call him, the Con.
Oh, going straight down
good hands
the
by Greg.
Right of the Whittles. Back over to Mitchie. He's just racking now. Just racking the posies up over the centre.
Still don't feel he's impacted the game, and he's turned the ball over a couple of times.
The outside of the boot, just flicks it up to the shiny boots man himself.
Harry Old.
Old Nully just going again. And why? There's a bit of rushing going on by the Western Island team. They're not being composed here at all, Craig.
No.
I'm a little surprised. It's normally their feature, their composure.
Onkers look a lot better footy. Going forward than Western. You nailed it there, Ben.
Yeah, there's a quick play on. Oh, and Leroy's all over. By himself. Now he's got this.
Off.
And again, what's he going to do? Inside, yeah, the numbers are there. He's got, they're breaking through, just absolutely. And
Anthony Dempsey.
Oh, there's a setup. Oh, whoa. That was from shiny boots.
I feel he just took the arms and the ball rather than anybody.
Yeah, no, it was a good solid hit. Good solid, you know what? You enjoy that side Gaelic footy, just a bit of physical.
And good old Harry there from Dawes Road Recycling. If you got any cans and bottles to be recycled, get yourself down to Dawes Road and have a good yarn with the boys and
yeah, they actually look after the plates of TK Print too. So yeah, do they? What about plumbing? Will you go down there for them too?
Mate, they come and pick up my empty hot water units, my copper and all sorts.
Nice. And Jamie just knocks one.
Now we go back to the TK Print scoreboard and we've got Western Island solitary point to Onkers 1-4.
Yeah, so seem to have one hand on the Hannikin. Already, this early stage of the game.
Andy Chris Groom. Imagine giving him up for, say, Andrew McLeod. Fremantle. Same colours as Fremantle.
As they push forward again, there just seems to be a lot more Onkers numbers back behind the footy. And Western are just look up and see players. It's just floating in their half of the field.
There's the great Shawnee Dunn's just come past us, pick up his phone, doing the line.
And now...
probably the best...
And we got Jackie. Oh, here's Harry. He just loves a bit of space and running, the big fella. He gives it back inside to Jack. Jack now Jake. Hands it... Jake. I do call him Jack quite often.
Munster. I did too.
Oh, and then so Jack now, is he settling? Is he settling? Oh, that's a nice little goal. That was really good composure. Over. Point. Yes, I know. Sorry. My bad, Craig. There's my AFL just coming back into me when it put it big through the big sticks. It's normally a sausage roll, but yes, just the solitary point there.
Just pop it, lad.
Just a little quick play on. Oh, he's gone to ground. This could be costly. They're pushing forward again. Ant's got it. He does love it from here. And doesn't miss. Yeah, there point. It is. He can't be turning over there. Right in the middle. Old Junior Crate, the old Ben, he slipped over at the one point of time.
I think the bright light and the reflection got in his eyes there. It does, can make it difficult.
Maybe it was a reflection from Toasty's Guernsey there. It's a bit bright. Oh, that's a solid deep kick, and it's just not quite hitting the mark at the moment.
He's taking his time to put that up. I wouldn't have allowed that myself.
Yeah, he's kicking backwards,
coughing
it up.
Robbie, I'll tell you, the Western Island guys have a lot of nice things to say about Rob.
And now they're pushing forward again.
Les Burdett been out of the play for a while. Good
to
see him back.
I think he must have been on the bench, mate. He must have just been having a breather, surely, because they've got their full quota, which is unlike them. They normally like playing on a pretty lean bench. They followed the. Is there something going on here? I think there might be. There's a bit of argy bargy going on here. I think Jamie's trying to settle it down, just tell his boys just to calm down and.
Just look like I don't shake anyone's hands. Got a little aggressive in there, and he's taking himself off, bringing Carrot back on.
Oh, there's a bit of voice from Mitchie. He's
Salmonella.
Yeah, he's.
How good was he last year in the
state
Australasian championship?
Oh, yes.
Putting the ball over the bar to knock off Vaughney and his boys from Geelong. Shout out to Heels and Vaughney and Root.
And the Rooper.
Talking about Root, man crushes. Dr. Cookie.
So. Is Ant going to give him just another settler? He pops it and pops it over the bar.
Doesn't get too much of the ball, does Ant? But what he does, he just is special. He's fantastic. He's nearly Cyril Rioli's special.
Well, Dom's definitely now trying to get the composure back. He's taken 3.5 hours to get this ball back into play. There's no exaggeration either.
That'd be a good move.
Yeah, the extended time is not great when you're playing. You're used to a 20-minute half and it goes out to 30.
Oh, there's a blowout. Oh, it's gone to Mikey.
But finally.
Mikey, good kick.
Finally
Mikey.
Tap one over.
Shep.
There's the old Shep over the Leroy.
Marsh has the bounce. Gives it off to Coakes. Haven't said his name for a little while.
They've hardly
really
had the ball,
need
right?
him back in, yeah. Back out to Salmonella. The Canadian Salmonella bear hunt. He's just shaking
bacon. Mitch, oh, he's coming back. He got a free. He got a little tackle.
You tell me how long the advantage rule goes for? Because I feel like it chops and changes weekly. Especially let me talk to the decision.
Special comments over the referees.
So we got from our referee coach, five coach, 5 seconds. Toasty's happy to play 10, 12, 8, 3, 1.
Just whatever he feels. It's okay. He's a ref. He's allowed to.
It's probably a bit like the difference I put my toast in the toaster compared to my wife and kids.
You know, it depends if you've got crumpets, though. You know, you've got to cook crumpets for longer.
I'll tell you, crumpets with tomato sauce. Have you tried it?
No.
Top notch. Get on board.
And then back in, and this is over.
That's a good point by Jamie.
See, I think that having Jamie pop it for them has been Mitchie just, not feeling it today.
He's an out-and-out superstar. I heard a story about him in Ireland and injured his lip and went back and became goalie and did a wonderful kick out long down the line, and there was a contest and Bevan took it off hands and gave it to some kid. I'm not sure who he was. I think he was a captain, I'm not sure of his name, and came back, got it and sacked it against South Africa. So that was
they had a good chance, South Africa. Anyway, we digress. Then
Macy
is just pushing forward. He's hardly had any of the footy lately. There's not really been the feeding that he's used to. There's been a couple of tackles that old Toasty's letting that go at the moment. Jamie's just... Oh, he's taking his legs out. Oh,
it's
in the back.
A little front on from Rob. The Western Islands players have nice things to say about Rob. Have I mentioned that?
Yes, you have a couple of times there, Craig. Yeah. Lovely.
I'll tell you my concern. I actually think that Western have got their match-up on Maisie wrong.
Who have they got on him?
Adam Floriani.
Yeah, okay. Maybe they're sacrificing that. They're just letting that one go through. Let them have that high. Maybe not hurt him as much.
So we've just had a message come in from the great Vow, the leader of the Flinders O'Neills out here. And his message is, great commentary, lads. I'm loving how noobs
spelled N-E-U-B-S, keep saying over the bar in an Irish accent.
Patrick Potato. At least it's actually an Irish accent. Sometimes when I do it, it turns into Indian. I don't know how or why. Whoop, there's a pop too. A couple of balloons going left and right. Anyway, Macca pushing the ball forward. Robbie got it now. Bit of composure. The run's just not there. Now Macca, they're trying to hold, they're just holding possession, which is fine. Les gave an option. Robbie's back inside. Yeah, there he is there, giving the option. Oh, Clunny with a bit of class.
Clunny from 1988, is he?
Oh, not with that. But hey, just pushing it forward. There's
classy.
Les. Oh, there's a tackle.
He is classy, he's Clunny. What he lacks in athleticism, he brings with skill and nous.
I must say, that's, well, we, you know, may say that the boys are carrying a few extra kegs. They're definitely, that's where why they're so competitive. They're just so skillful. I'm talking to someone that needs some kegs on their boot is Ant, but as he now pops it over the bar.
The disappointing one for me so far has been Mark Elliott. I remember when we played him, the young fella, unfortunately for him, engaged in conversation with me, and yeah, he really hasn't been sighted today.
You know, the one I haven't seen for a while is old Miller. He's gone drifting. You know, like he was. There's a bit of Joe Dirt about it, the old Miller at the moment, and I'm
more than a bit.
I think he needs to get into the play a bit more if Onkers are going to get.
I've got a feeling
in front of this.
He came in today on a deck chair full of balloons, and he had to pop them one by one to land.
Anyway, Onkers are pushing forward now.
Demps again.
They've gone through with Demps.
Bit of a solo, puts it on to Tommy.
Tommy
with a bounce to solo.
Is he
going to
cut inside?
Andy Mack.
Oh, he's coughed that left. But hang on, has he?
I thought that was clean, raisin toast, but he's called it.
Yes.
Each their own.
Well, Tony must be very happy at the moment with the state of free kicks.
I think that's the first one Onkers have got from Tony's report.
Well, there's been maybe one or two, but yeah, definitely that one there was on Tony's request.
I will say, I'm looking at Tony right now. He looks like a water boy, but he's drinking it himself.
That's Jamie. Lines up. He just does a little 9-iron there and pops it straight over the bar.
That was nothing like my 9-iron on Nudes. They don't generally get off the ground these days.
I heard you played McCracken today and saw a lot of the water.
Hit 72, though. Take my handicap off and I hit 72.
All right, Lewis. Wasted no time there because he knows he's got that 1k an hour breeze. Pops it forward. Going to the big fella. It's a good matchup. Look at that clunk. Well, I'm not sure that was Turteen either.
No, not Turteen. Jackie
oh,
Andrews.
Oh, yes. A lot of space.
As I mentioned earlier, if you haven't been to Burdett Hall, find it on the map and go and have a look.
Then Harry gets tackled from behind, but has he? Oh, he has. Those brand new boots.
And that's half time.
Have definitely served purpose now. And not so much Sheen on that. So stay with us for a while. We might just have a...
We'll get out there and have
a quick
chat
little roam. Roaming Bev and Ben. Don't worry about roaming Brian. He's got nothing on us. Craig's moving the fastest he's moved all year. Over to you there, Craig. Straight in. Yep.
Righto, guys. I've got Tommy with me now. Good start to that game. What did you think? How you going?
Yeah, we had a good start. And they kind of fucking pulled back there through the half. We started to get back on top of them and they got a nice point. Then they let to within a goal in. But no, good game all around. Yep. A few hard hits out there.
Yeah. No, great start. You're very good out there, mate.
Alright, let's pull it out.
Yeah.
so it was kind of just tough getting to the first few games, which were Friday nights from work. But yeah, and ended up playing the last three, but not enough to qualify.
Played enough to beat us, or you're very good against us.
It's always hard though, they're always fired up.
Personally, I think it's a physical game. I think you want that out of a grand final, but you know, the same token, you've got to make sure that they've got that in check, because the last thing you want to do is have yourself influence a game, I would have thought.
Yeah.
But if you have to, you will, I would guess.
Yeah, I don't like, it's the last thing I like doing. I don't like influencing games. I like to let it flow, and I hope you would have seen that. I think both teams are going too physical a little bit at the moment. Both teams got a warning just then. There was a little bit going on behind play, and I've just warned both teams to say, hey, anything. If I think I see anything behind play, I'm going to give cards.
Look, I understand that totally. And we're here to obviously watch two teams go at it, and that's the main thing. Yeah. So good luck in the second half, mate.
Thanks, mate.
Give us a test, 1-2 on the mic quickly. Actually, I have to go out. Ow. Oh.
they're definitely putting a lot of pressure on us for sure, but we're just panicking a little bit instead of taking that extra second, finding the easy man, throwing some hand passes away, kicking when we don't need to, shots from where we shouldn't be shooting from, but I think we finished on top in the second half, so hopefully we can get that going. And
I know with St. Brendan's, one thing we found with Western Ireland was you guys ran the ball really well. Onkers are pushing back. Did you discuss that at halftime?
So we find going up the hill, this is generally where we play better. We can run, carry. That's something that we're lacking a little bit. We're lacking the options a little bit in that first half. The goal is just keeping hands, keep it off the foot as much as possible and just run it forward and just try and stream as much as possible. We got numbers and we're just trying to use them a bit more as well. Keep the fitness, make sure we can keep running.
Brilliant, mate. Thanks. Good luck.
Just quickly, by other players that are coming out, what was on at halftime?
Basically, like we did in the second half of that half, just start getting the composure, try and break some lines and run it out.
Yeah, definitely thought your first half you started a bit slow, so hopefully in the second half you can start things off a bit quicker. Yep. Good, thanks, mate.
Cheers.
Early goal, and I thought it was some good run from you from the back half. What did you think of the first half?
Not bad run. Hopefully don't let Western Ireland run all over us now and just, I don't know.
What did they have to say at halftime they want from you this half?
Keep doing what we're doing. Composure, hard running.
Yep. I found you pushing back really hard as a group and really congesting them. Yeah. Good luck, guys.
Give me some time to reset up for you boys and we're done. Man, do you want to come collect these?
Get it forward. Over to Coakes. Coakes definitely early touch in this quarter. Could be the telling difference if he gets touches early. Down away though, their hierarchy of quality players are definitely getting touches early in this second half. And then Meso, oh geez, that's a good quality touch early. And he finishes and pops it, you know where, over to Barr.
Good player is Maisie. Runs at it hard. He's physically strong. In fact, he intimidates me just looking at his haircut.
I've only got positive things to say. I don't want to see him in the car park after.
No, that's why he intimidates me. Lewis comes out this outer side, inner side, whatever side we are on.
Jake, he's taking his side. Oh, that's
Herman Munster.
Oh, that is definitely high. Oh, he wants to go on with it. Yeah. Oh, yes. Yep. Oh, there's a bit of feeling in this second half. I like it. Now Mitchie settles. Where is he? Just perusing, looking left, looking right. Nails it like Mitchie does.
Good to see him keep one inside the boundary there, Mitch. Not like the first half.
Oh, see? Oh, Marcus, uncharacteristic. Oh, normally silk.
Les Burdett, tell you what, creates a good curator on a good pitch. So Carrot
just
taking the kick
top,
in.
I don't think as well. I'm a bit like myself.
Carrot Burgundy. No, not happy with the options.
He's looking for Jamie. Yes, well played. Nice little kick there.
What do you think of the one sock up, one sock down by Jamie?
Oh, well, he's had a broken leg, so it's just probably, just protecting his leg with that one. But I do think it's pretty odd. Oh, nice little poke forward. But they got the numbers back. Harry playing in front, as good defenders do. Mitchie, just the class off half back here. Gives it off to see the silk.
Yeah, sure hands.
You can't keep
sure
him out of the game for long. And Ant, what's he going to do? He looks like he was turning over his own shadow. But that's all right. He had composure, gave it over to Jackie, and we've got it. Oh, that's a beautiful score.
How's Jack Andrews strut afterwards? He knew what was going on there.
Mate, if we had the best seat in the house for that goal.
Cracking
that was
kid.
Beautiful. It was fantastic, to be honest.
Something that I reckon Big Vaughny from Geelong, something he would do. Piece him through, pop him over.
Thanks for that, Mills.
64-inch police hat he has to wear.
Biggest head in the business. Behind Ebert, of course.
No, anyway, it's bigger than Ebert's.
So Mitchie just crumbs it nicely. Oh, breaking ball, sorry. And Jackie just, they've got the first couple of points here. Or the first score is definitely heading their direction. But no, it's a bit short. It's just like old Jackie is a bit short, really. Just, pushing out of defence.
Demps again, boys. Comes out.
Oh, that's that composure we're talking about with ball in hand. That old Wado then pushes forward again. Doesn't cough it up. Just knows where to go. Pops it forward. Old Tommy. Spins one way. Spins the other. And Leroy, oh, this could go anywhere. Duck for cover. Nah. He hand off. He knows his limitations.
Stocky. Stocky's put it wide. He's a big boy, Stocky. He was very good against the Taints last week. But as we have a quick look at the Bevan Plumbing scoreboard, we've got Western Island on 7 points to Onkers, one goal seven.
Well, they've got the ball on quick. This is unlike them. They normally take their time.
Greg Whittlesey flicks it out wide. He's got Andy Chris Groom, who goes on to Clunny the Keg. Flicks it on to Brad Haskett. I play three games in thongs and qualifier. Takes on the body of Milk Crate. Gives it back to Jack Andrews. Flicks it out to smooth move Mitch Portlock. Tell you what, for...
Taking his legs, the old Ron Burgundy. That's a usual trick.
It just flicks it on. I've got a feeling that's young Elliot's first touch. And that could be his second, but it doesn't count because he's touched the ball on the ground there, the Keg Clunny.
Oh, Mitch is just starting to come into the game here. A couple of telling touches. Now, Dom is taking... No, he's not taking this kick. Just
no, because it's a free kick, so yeah. Mikey can take it out of the hands.
Yeah.
Oh, just put it out.
Space.
That's out in front of Silver Fox. Shakes and bakes, comes inside, flicks it off to Demps. Demps inside to the Carrot. Carrot now with one bounce and puts it back in towards Maisie.
Kick.
Oh, Maisie with a bit of a fumble.
It could
flicks
hurt.
It out, and here is the reflector.
Hang on. The reflector. Who's just come onto the field?
He has come on to settle them down back
John
there,
Floriani, the senior journeyman. Here he is, himself.
Turnover, we've got Western Island, gives a handball inside of the cheese platter. Has a bounce, a solo. Another bounce, he's coming through centre-half back. Another solo as he runs at Salmonella. Salmonella runs away, puts it in front of Ant.
Ant just flick over the top.
Just a little knock-on, just enough to keep it in front of him.
Yeah.
Jackie Andrews.
Good old Joe Dirt just didn't know what was coming there, did he, Craig?
Oh, it's tough as a 16-year-old.
Yeah, there's a
Jackie
bit of
Andrews, shake and bake.
Oh, that's high. Yeah, had to be paid. Nah.
Probably a couple in there.
Sorry, yeah. Shep.
Probably a couple in there, probably even one earlier.
Just go and calm down. That was definitely...
I think he has paid the one earlier and he's going back with the advantage where we get 5 seconds. It's coming from the top, 5 seconds.
I wonder if John gets a pension discount for his subs. Do you reckon?
Surely.
You'd think so these days.
Surely.
He probably nearly did a calf just walking out in the field today. But
don't
anyway.
Call me Shirley. Have a look at him though, the general back there. Hands on hips.
Lines up. Oh, he's got under that ball. That's a Barry Crocker.
Have you ever seen John Flo man up on anybody? Ever?
Nah. When you're that good, you don't need to, really. For that long. Or maybe you just can't catch him.
Yeah, class. Dom Long again. We've got Stocky,
in front.
He's done that well. He's given the handball off to Shep. Shep's kicked it down the line to Salmonella. Where's Salmonella going? He's going to Maisie. No, that's Tommy.
Yep.
Tommy will do something here. Watch him. Go to Maisie.
Maisie tried to spend it.
I feel he's just going to bully Adam Floriani back there. I just don't think they've got that one right. Tommy again.
Oh, there's a tackle, but that was let go. Oh, there's a bit of composure there from Coates. Just, you know, just...
Maisie, he's going to have a shot from there.
On his left. Yeah, that was always going to go wide. Yeah. That was a bit ambitious.
Probably worth a shot. Oh, I feel he needed to have the shot there, Maisie. I think everything you've done is great. Everything. Mitch Portlock, can he get down to it? Oh, I think he's done a hamstring. No, he's right.
It's a bit like the... one of our Taints boys that might have been over and did something during the year and did a calf and also let some gas go.
Yeah, good old Tim Dunks. That's a shout out to you, mate, with the bend over and fart.
It's the only play all year that I've ever heard someone do that on a field.
One game, one fart, they call him. He didn't wear thongs like Brad Haskett on the outer side.
As he
goes solos, a tat.
They nickname him Haviana.
Haviana, yeah. In fact, I'm pretty sure they named those thongs after Brad Haviana Haskett. Oh,
he's shiny boots. Have a look at him. Just a man model, really, isn't he?
He is. I think this is what hurt him in the first half, the slow play. They need to get the ball moving.
Yeah, that's 100% agree there, Craig. When they break the line or they allow Onkers to get back, they just can't break it. Oh, that's in the back. Oh, and on the ground. So which one do you want to pay there, Toasty? None, he says. Oh, Shepherd, you've got the space now. Are you going to go? No, you're going to turn it over.
Oh, the
reflector.
Straight
to the loose man in defence. The general. He actually looks a bit Phil Smythe-like, to be honest.
He does look Phil Smythe-like. Shout out to Phil. I know he's listening today.
And Mitch, he just runs forward. Just the ball just looks like a juggler in his hands. Just so smooth. Hardly touches his foot before it's back up. And then Ant's just...
For a big guy, he moves quite well.
Yeah.
Good turn and of speed.
Just turning it over the Les and do? Les just... Oh, has it curled? Has it curled? No,
nah.
Not enough.
Didn't roll that pitch well enough.
Yeah, he had the lean going on to try and get it in, but just didn't lead hard enough. So the Bevan Plumbing scoreboard has Western Ireland, 7 points. Onkers, 1 goal, 7 points. So just up by 3, the old Onkaparinga. Dom pushes it forward. That's a big, solid kick. But they've got that. They've read that well. Playing on. This is the more what we were talking about. If Western are going to come back into this game, they need to be playing on forward quicker. Oh, I'm not sure that was a play there, Marcus.
Would you say panic?
Oh, I think he tried to catch the goalie off guard.
Bit
but
of
I think
panic
he caught
from Les Burdett Hall.
Off guard.
What do you reckon Dom's going to do here?
Probably go long.
Yeah, okay. Something different.
Yeah.
Take a risk.
The go long Dom, they call him.
Have we got a free kick update from Tony Conlon?
Yeah, 300,052.
To two. That's the first two free kicks Onkers have had all season, apparently.
Oh, good to see Robbie here on his crutches. Up you get. Take that. Nice, solid mark.
Quiet achiever, the Demps.
Oh, lovely ball in. What have they got here? They've got a few boys out wide on the wing. No, Oweda hasn't found him. Old Ron Burgundy, what's he going to do? He sends it forward and sends it wide.
Bloody Carrot Gregory.
Mate, need to be kicking them. Had 5 minutes free just to have his composure. It was a big miss by the old Onkers. Could be costly later in the game.
But Lewis again. Really hasn't shone a light on his kickouts today. We'll see what he can do here. Shakes and bakes and comes back round. He goes to the outer side and he goes long towards Greg Whittlesey and Jack Noonan. Haven't seen much of Jack Noonan.
Yeah.
Onkers have taken it. Maisie, I reckon that's come off Maisie, but it's still in play. Paulie flicks it in. Well,
that's a good tackle from Maisie. In another game, that's holding the ball.
Yeah, not your fault, Maisie. It's the rules. Change them. Western Ireland play on quickly. Jack Noons.
Yeah, chip inside. There's a couple of free men pushing forward now. Les is just
to
all
Rob.
By himself. He doesn't want to give it to him. He's actually burned him. Big bumps and burner there.
Hard to believe. Rob's only 19.
Yeah, but see, Marcus just works forward and gets it again. Now they've created the loose man. He has a ping and pops it. Pops it over the bar. Oh, and points to the crowd. His mum must be here. You're beauty. Hi, mum.
Not sure which one of those ladies over there is his mum, but big shout out to Nolly or Nully's mum.
Yeah, I think...
Or is it the other kid?
No, I think that was Kirk.
Kirk, yeah. Kirk-nick.
That's the old Kurtnick.
Kurtnick.
Would have actually been his first touch of the game, so maybe that's why he's celebrating so hard. But yeah, very good to get him back into this as Western pop it forward.
Long sleeves and Brighton shorts. I'm not sure he's required, the tan Brighton coffee club.
Maybe he's just a bit sun conscious there, Craig, and just, it's his SPF coda. Doesn't want to get done by the rays, There's a few white boys out here that might get burnt.
Onkers going forward and Wado.
Oh, there's
Wado pops it over the bar. He's been doing that for 45 years.
It's a pity he's only 20. Wow. Just the answer straight away, eh?
Still only a goal in it. It's a nice tight final. It's what we want to see. West Nile have won the last three.
There's a couple of loose men. Has he found him in time? I think he has. The big Jake. Jake
Herman
the
Munster.
Snake. Oh, it's a
and
lovely
he's put it up.
Take.
And he's kicked
plays
it.
On. Oh, where's
the reflector.
Loose Floriani? Oh. That's usual loose Floriani, as they
there's
like
Rob.
To say. Just numbers are getting back. The Onkers numbers.
19-year-old Rob. A couple of Western Island guys think he's okay. Comes out of the cheese platter.
Hang on, what's Platter doing up there?
I don't know.
I think he's a defender.
He's not going to kick it, is he?
That's why defenders don't play. Oh, there's a man down. There's a man down behind play. What's happened here? Oh. Anyway, so big hazard. Good contest. Bang. The male model. Love it. Yeah, we've noticed there's a man down behind play. Didn't actually see it. Didn't know if it was a knee or a hit behind or what. It's a knee, is it?
Is that Leigh? Because reports have it that Leigh did a groin before half-time.
That's ripped off the bone now.
Yeah, possibly. Feel like we need to get a wambulance out to him.
Can we do a roaming Bevo Ben out there? Do you reckon they'll allow that?
It is Leigh.
Just solid punch there by Harry to get that over the fence to allow this ref time.
He was very good, Leigh, against St. Brendan's. Oh, Lee's up. He's right now. Yep. No, his broken leg's now recovered.
To milk something.
You can hear Coakes there. He wants to put your foot down for 10 and we'll go real hard here.
So they want to put the pressure on now because they're up by 3. If they get out by 6 or 7, that will be the game. So
have you ever seen Coakes run? Because, mate, he can put the foot down. Well, and he would go for longer than 10.
His Strava account every other week does a half marathon. So, yeah, I have seen him run. Well, his Strava account anyway.
Is that a dive by Jamie? Steps! Sorry.
In the back and dive. Yeah, Jamie. Well, he's getting a bit vocal towards raising toast there. It's very uncharacteristic.
Well, Leigh's scoring mustn't be too bad. And here's
Joe Dirt. Joe Dirt's got it forward. And he's got it into space to Maisie. Oh, Maisie, again, he's just... I don't want to say too much because I don't want to see him in the car park. That's great off the boot. Yeah, well done, mate. Oh, that was class.
He's been the difference. He has. He actually kicked the goal.
I think Weston are just walking at the moment. At the moment, they don't feel the same.
Rattled.
I feel at this moment in the game that they if they don't lift their work rate just that little bit more, the game will get beyond them.
Where's their leadership? They need the reflector. They need Andy Small Hands Mac. They need Mitch Portlock to stand up and really galvanise this group and make the difference.
And that 16-year-old Robbie as well. We need him to get back into the game if they're going to get back into the game.
Yeah, good bloke, I hear.
Yeah, Ben Newbury thinks so too. Shout out there into Copland. Oh, Vice Cop Vorney.
What's Salmonella going to do with this one?
He pops it into the goals. Jamie hits it and nearly. Oh, that's a good attempt there from Onkers. They get that sack, that onion bag, and that is nearly the game, I would think. Oh, lovely commentary from behind.
Short, and Greg Whittlesey down the middle. Flicks a handball on a little hands Macca, who, I don't know, I think he was a little scared of the contact coming. Gets around Tommy, couple of solos, pushes it forward and turns it over to Joe Dirt, goes through his hands.
Oh, Ant, that could
keep your feet, Ant. Dempsey's come in. Oh, Macca's followed up. Oh, how good's Macca been? He's
the milk
really
crate got down.
There.
Wow, and then he coughed it up. She's no milk today.
No. Joe Dirt, over to Leroy.
A
little solo, flicks it on.
And he found a target.
Leigh, I've done a groin, broken my leg and passed away, but I'm okay to play.
Yeah.
Jamie kicks it on, comes back out to Leroy, shake and bake. Leigh,
it was a shadow, mate. He wasn't shaking, baking anything there.
I didn't say what he shook and book.
Shook and book. The old shook and book. Oh, what do they got? Good idea there. Just drop it. Let it, the class of Jamie, just park it.
Weston need a onion bag from here.
Yeah, if they're going to get back into the game, there is no doubt. Maybe at halftime, I had a couple of snag and wagon burgers.
And just for everyone out there, snag and wagon at Harvey Norman Woodville every Saturday, 9 till 4. Get your snag and your wagon on it at Harvey Norman.
It's Jamie. Jamie Conlon puts it forward. Oh, that's well wide. Yeah. Normally expect better. Maybe Mitch will take them from now on.
Back to Salmonella Mitch.
Yeah, that is Salmonella Mitch. Old Shiny Boots Hazza just strutting out. Still like he's got a bit to give in this second half if the Western are going to get back into this. Oh, and then he goes short, old Lewis.
Andy Chris Groom, solo. bounce, flicks it on, goes to Robbie, 12-year-old Robbie, goes out to
he's
Greg
Benjamin
Whittlesey.
Button like, isn't he? He's getting younger.
Greg Whittlesey, couple
by the commentary.
Couple
he's going to be 12.
Flicks it in. We've got Les Burdett. They've got a little bit of movement now, but just slowed it up again. You've got to go through him, Jack. Take him on.
He hasn't had any more. That is rubbish. You know what? Havaianas just didn't expect that.
Nah, I think he's underdone, Haviana.
Oh, he definitely looks like he's got to go sit down. Yeah. Oh, they popped it forward to the Maize Dog and just got the numbers.
Andy Chris Groom.
Oh, he's holding the ball again. Yep.
I think that was a wrong decision there, Toasty. Like, should have been all Maisies.
Oh, as they just
heard it here
run
first,
forward.
Maisie. Paulie. I had the fortuity to do a goal last couple of weeks ago behind the goals with Paulie's dad.
Oh, quick little movement by Weston. Oh, there's a little rumble going on here between us. Yeah, right in front of the commentary area here. There's a bit physicality, and Leroy just comes in and tells him, how's your father?
I just heard shirt rip.
Oh, Leroy, he doesn't mind putting the guns out, eh?
Nully just dropped the sitter and then picks it up as it's rolling. Brain fart there.
Oh, I love Leroy. He goes and belts a bloke in the chest, rips his shirt, then taps him on the bum and trips him accidentally, and then goes, oh, you're right, mate, I didn't mean to trip you. Oh, sorry about that.
He's first got a lovely smile, does Leroy. Nice, big, white, shiny porcelain teeth.
Oh, what's John doing forward? Does he actually know that's the forward half of the pitch?
The reflector, back to Null.
What's going on
back
here?
Back to John.
Oh, dear.
Gives it on. Oh. Marcus, back to Nully.
Sack. Oh, if they're coming back into it, now could be the time.
Yeah, I'll tell you, Nully's made many mistakes, but he's made up for it with that.
Is he taking his jacket off as well? Did he have an undergarment as well, didn't he?
The other kid, number 12.
The old Koenig.
Koenig,
the old Koenig. I thought they both had one, but hey, maybe he just had his hair flicking his face. But well done. That was a lovely goal by the Nullster.
Stocky.
Oh, he's played on. Oh, he hasn't. Yeah, I feel the pressure's now picked up in this game. The tempo's definitely there. The old Salmonella. Oh, nice fake. Selling kid to candy. Kid candy to kid or kid to candy? Wow.
I don't know what you do in the spare time, Higgs, but there's a wide by the second crate.
Yeah, more lesser unknown, but hey.
Shep. Do we call him the Shep crate? Because, you know, high value the Shep crate these days. Milk crate still hanging around the back half on his own, just playing the loose. I think it's milk crate loose and reflector loose for Western Island. Lewis
this
has come along
to
Haviana. It's going over
back.
The top.
Oh, he
well read.
Reads it.
Marcus Burdett, just too classy.
Pick it up. That was a big call from old Havianas, telling his own teammate to pick it up when he was nowhere near the ball. But anyway, as they move forward,
Greg
we digress.
Dempsey flicks it out to the ever-reliable Wado. Goes out to Ron Burgundy. Carrot kicks it short. Oh, and Adam Floriani's actually had a better half this half on Maisie, but Maisie's still the best player on the ground.
As they just cash it forward. Oh, where Western did he ball. Pluck that from? Oh, hang on. Oh, he pushed back and used his body back. You can't be doing that, yep. Rightio.
Well ref there by Raisin Toast. And the snag wagon.
At a Harvey Norman's near you. Oh, that was a bit high, but
over
play on advantage.
Yeah, played advantage.
Played
5 seconds of advantage.
Oh, another one.
And
that's two.
So was that 5 seconds from the first one?
Play on doesn't happen, I don't think.
He's allowing
double advantage.
It. Comes out Haviana. Haviana found some space.
I think he was just tired from the last contest, to be honest. But it's all right. As he just, there's a shepherd there. Oh, gave him, gave Joe Dirt some time to do something himself, and Mitch on the outside of the boot has kicked it wide, but old ref Raisin Toast, has he brought it back?
Had Jack Noonan on the outer side there. He had made some space, and you've got to back yourself. But
look, sometimes you just need to take the game upon yourself, and that was what Mitchie is as usual does. But on this occasion, right of screen, went wide.
Oh, Nolly over the back. Here's Jack Noonan. It's something good that happens when he gets the ball. Class act. Goes out to, is it Marcus Elliott out there? Hard to see with these old age eyes.
Yeah, number seven is Marcus Elliott. Yep. Yes, it is. Oh, no, just Mark, actually. He's a Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch over to Jack.
Jackie Andrews.
Jack with a bit of composure.
That's wide as well. Yeah. I feel like Western Island have taken over control here.
But they're just not giving damage, though. As we look over to the
Jeez, you're not Bevan my wife, Plumbs. You're not my wife. Let me finish.
Bevan Plumbing scoreboard.
We have Western Island 1-8 to Onkers 1-8. So for those of you who aren't mathematicians out there, the scores are even.
Nice contest there.
Yeah, I like that contest. Play that on.
No, definitely.
Nolly again, flick gets it, gives it the cheese platter, dirty moustache, flicks it on. Filth. Back to Nolly. Nolly's turned it on this half. I tell you, he's one who at half time probably caught the roast from Mitch Portlock. Well, Jack Noons, out of sight. It's hard to see, but Nolly again. The goal scorer for Western. Now we've got Les Burdett. He's going to be some class.
Oh, handle that over, mate. You could have just gone with the booze.
Just pop it, lad. Pop it over the bar.
Just handle it over when you got that much time and effort and made all the right decisions until the end. Just went wide. So there's a nice crowd here of about 150 people. It's lovely. Enjoying a nice little Sunday afternoon out at St. Mary's Park.
Well, I believe it's a record for the season, most attendances for the season. Dom hasn't really laced that one, Connie, but it's come out here to
milk
crate. Not sure, is that?
Yeah, no, salmonella.
I thought I saw that tissue on the ground, but it doesn't appear to be.
No, it was full. There's some physical.
That's not a card. Nothing in it, Maisie. Unlucky.
Just solid body work. I don't think, there might be a tick or two in there, but to be honest, I think it was just part of the game. Two guys having a contest and it wasn't that high. What's he doing?
Tony's just told me that the Western Island player actually instigated the contact and it should be an Onkers free kick worth double points.
So what you're telling me is they should be having a penalty right now?
Yeah, penalty.
Fair enough.
Yep. Tell you, it's one-way reffing. I tell you, it's all Western Island's way, apparently.
So there was a card given. I think it was just a yellow, though.
I think that was just to appease the Western Island supporters. But
War Tony.
Well, did the yellow go to Western Island or did it go to Onkers? Because surely it should have been Western Island.
This could be another little movement in the game. It could just be a telling moment. They've taken Jackie off.
Yeah. I think he's got a bruised sternum.
He's not looking great. A couple of people are helping him off the pitch.
It's 8-year-old Rob's back on. He's looking absolutely fancy out there, the young fella. Just a clean set of heels.
One interesting little matchup here, Macca on Jamie. Not sure that they would like that for much longer. Not really criticising Macca much, but Jamie's about 4 foot higher.
I think Jamie's little finger is bigger than Macca's whole hand.
And now we're just going back. Yeah, rightio. Just
so we can play it on. That's a good move by the cheese platter. Just likes that little flick back onto the foot when he does his solos and just gives it up to Coates. His direct opponent.
Turnover.
Tommy, what's Tommy going to do?
What's Tommy going to do? Is there someone cutting inside? Is there? Is there numbers?
Dimps.
And wow, that was a big turnover by the cheese platter. Oh, yes. So that puts him up by the one on the Bevan Plumbing scoreboard there at Western Island. 1-8 to Onkaparinga. 1-9.
Time left. Ooh, it looks like we're at 27 minutes. We've got 3 minutes to go, and Onkers up by one.
That's plus injury time there, Craig. So we've probably got about 5 minutes of injury time with a couple of things that played down too.
Leigh break his leg and pass away, and then we had the.
Oh no, but we should nickname him Jesus because he's now back from the dead.
I cannot repeat Mitch Portlock's response there, which was something along the lines of, "I think you kicked me. Please move off."
Yes. Oh, there's a couple of big challenges there. This is getting a bit desperate now. I like it. I like the game. It's a bit physical. I think Tommy now might be a bit tired after those four contests in a row. And, in, yep, hands are on knees. So over to you, Craig.
Bring cheese platters, flicked it into Herman Munster. Comes back out to Little Hands. Little Hands flicks it on to Jackie Andrews, Seven's best player. Goes out to the old man, Ant. Straightening up now, Mitch, shake and bake, and just stops and just lost all momentum. Flicks it back out to this side to the big Jake, the big Herman Munster. Takes the ball, flicks inside to the cheese platter. We're about 20 out from
amends,
goal now.
Trying
shakes
to make
and bakes.
His turnover
gives
before.
It to Les Burdett. Flicks it, pops it over the bar. It's one thing, you never lose your class. While he hasn't had the best of days, you've always got your class there, and Les Burdett has rolled that pitch beautifully.
You know what I liked? Even though Onkers pushed all the way back, they just were composed and they broke it eventually. That was actually a good little point there from the guys.
We've got Coops here asking how much time's left, and we reckon we were about three to four minutes.
So, score's level here on the Bevan Plumbing.
No,
2 minutes
told
to go.
2 minutes.
By Shawnee Dunn, the legend of the Taints.
We did have a draw in the women's nine-a-side final today, and they did have to play extra time. And
who won that one, Craig?
The Blues. Yeah, the Blues rolled Flinders, and I was surprised by that.
I think we all were.
Yeah. If I haven't mentioned before, Hannah Constable, great golfer, plays off two. Plays up at Blackwood and hit herself a hole in one in 2020.
There's a big class turnover act. Now inside. What Onker's going to do? Now, class of
Cokes.
Of the Coakley just rolls and wants his team to roll forward with it. He just rolls sideways. Old Ron Burgundy Berg. Just running forward. He's pushing it forward to old. Oh, that's the Tommy. No, not Stocky. It was went over his head. Yep. But now we're over to. It's a good smother. How did he get his hands on that?
I think the Irish call it a block. It's a block, lad. It's not a smother.
Bob Macca, that was incredible. I don't know how those hands got up, those little arms and little hands. Good effort.
Fiercely fought contest. This has been an absolute delight to watch. Mitch Portlock now just starting to really come into his own. Comes out to Harry.
Good hard running.
Door Park Recyclers.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good tackle. Good challenges. Good. This is good Gaelic footy right now. I love it. She's now
just
inside
let it play
to the
toast,
Ant.
Just raisin toast. Didn't mind that. Old man Ant. Does he? No. Burn.
Just trying to keep composure
Burns
now.
The reflector.
There's a few tired bodies out there. A lot of hands on knees right now as Burdett just on the outside of the boot and it goes wide. Oh. Probably
that just could be the ambition getting in the way of reality, but being Les Burdett, I actually feel reality is he can kick that.
He can do whatever he wants, really. Exactly. Now Shep just chips it forward over the top. Oh, that was a good attempt.
Yeah,
to
held
stop
him
there.
Up enough. Depp, oh, that that's a throw. What's he going to pay there? Toasty's let that go. Jamie now running around onto his right, comes back onto his left. Just
this
Harry
is
held him up enough.
This is where Jamie comes into it. He may not be the fittest at the moment, not playing a lot of games, but they've thrown him forward to be the difference. Just with a couple of minutes to go, one would think.
Just got a message from Andrew Paddy Mills Milson, the Taints Life member, who won. Hang on, mate, the game's still going. If you log on to YouTube, you'll be able to watch the entertaining match.
And
Tommy,
this could be the match winner right there.
That could be enough.
It could be, because this game now is just going end to end. There's no real, there's attempts, but they're just not getting good looks at it at the moment.
Well, I feel this could be the last roll of the dice for the Western Island boys.
The crowd gets up and involved. Onkers are in it. Oh.
That's going
deep. There's a few bodies going forward. Oh, I didn't think he needed to do that. If he just grabbed that footy, that could have been what the team needed. But anyway, now the numbers are back like usual for Onkers. They love flooding their players back. Oh, Tony agreed with that. That was now free kick number three. It was 955,301 to Western Island. Three to Onkers. No, Tommy. But came at the right time of today. Now, Wado just gently forward to Shep. Now to Ron Burgundy. Under pressure. Now they've got into space, working it hard. Now back into the middle of the Coakley. He works hard, works so hard. He's pumped it forward. There's just space. There's just so much
Stocky.
Space to the
Stocky
stock man.
All on his own. I think he forgot to have a shower last night. He's got some BO on.
Amazing all there. And you know what?
Oh, he handballed it, and he handballed it wide. Who would have thought?
There's a blight on the game that you can handball it over for a point. Blight on the game, and Stocky, that was.
But maybe the wind decided they agree with that too.
Insipid.
He had all the time in the world. He could have waited for another day. And they pop it up, Lewis. Their own teammates are jumping into each other, and old Ron Burgundy just wants to clean it up. He wants his game set aside.
Stay classy, San Diego.
As Leroy just falls off.
Oh, he's handled it into the back of Salmonella.
He did.
And we've got 5 seconds. No, he's called it off now. No, no advantage. Out to Leroy.
Oh, Jamie. You need to be standing up on him. You can't be doing that this late in the game. Leaving Jamie Conlon all by himself.
That could be game over there, I think.
Oh, Weston, they might just be feeling the pinch here. That was pretty average defending. Is Floriani loose again? No, I can't see it.
Oh, the reflector is in here. Is play on? No, didn't pay that to Greg Whittlesey. Harry, that's not a good kick. But
it will work. It will.
If you want someone kicking, it's Ant. You want Ant kicking the
point. They need a onion sack here, mate. They need to. And Cheese, the Cheesemeister. Is he the board? There it is. Oh, dearie me. How did they pluck that out?
As I said earlier, Western Island have got this in the bag.
Oh, wowzers. Can you tell me what? That was unexpected. The flow was going all Onkers' way.
All or nothing here. Dom's gone short for the first time, and he goes to Cocahontas. Couple of solos. On he goes.
I think
is that
now,
Dempsey? Greg Dempsey comes inside
to
Cocahontas.
Johnny
Flo, the reflector.
And desperate. Desperation.
He's on the
Joe
ground.
Flo.
You can't take the ball when you're on the ground on your knees. Wow. Not sure John knew that rule, new to the game.
Only played 795 games, but yes, quite new today.
Actually took him kneeboarding early last year and, struggled.
Now they've got the milk crate.
Comes inside over the dead man walking.
Oh, he's,
and he's
just
turned it over.
It up to no one. What was going on there? Wow.
Robbie, I tell you, at three, he's moving very well for a three-year-old.
Over to Les. Now they know that they can just, if they keep possession of the game, if they keep possession here for the next few minutes, this will be it. I think they have it. Oh, I can't believe this. Mitchie just going back into the pocket.
Does he turn it over though?
The milk crate just having a go.
Front on.
Bang. Oh, and again, bang.
It might have hurt. I wouldn't, you know.
Oh, another balloon's just gone pop over here in the stands. They're just
Jackie
keeping
Andrews
possession.
Taking
he'll
on,
hold,
son.
He'll hold possession. He'll hand it back to the
back
gully.
To Lewis.
Back to the Louis. Lewis for Tom. Over the top.
Greg Whittlesey.
And there it is.
That's it.
Wowzers. Let's get out there for roaming. Bevan, men, let's get out there, all right?
Just waiting for some technical difficulties.
So we're here with Johnny Flo, who's played 739 games for Western. How does that feel, mate?
Up there with the best, mate. Really, really good.
Yeah.
We didn't play well, but we hung in there and just got at the end, mate. It was awesome.
Yeah, fantastic really effort there, the reflector. Really enjoyed your sweeping and a couple of good contests in here and your aggression. Even though it went against you, you held them up.
Got to do your best, mate, even if it's misplaced. But, mate, just really good and such for Paul. It's such a great result for him, so really happy.
What was it, a great result? Oh, yeah.
Paul's dad passed away this morning, so.
Oh.
Yeah. So, yep. Okay. But we had something to play for, and really glad we could get over the line for him and Roz. So
how many flags is that now here at Western Island for you, John?
It doesn't matter, mate. It's a few.
It does, I want to know.
Eight.
Eight. Well done, mate.
Just if you'd like to turn this way and see the people over in Streamland. A good win by our lads today, mate.
Yeah, absolutely, Hughes. It was a very, very hard fought win. We were down early though. They got off to a good start against us, and we knew that all day if we just could have kept at them, and you know, we hoped that our fitness prevailed. And as you see, in the last 9 seconds, we kicked that under. So
yeah, it was lucky that Cheesy actually pushed forward and helped that, because he helped turn over this one just over here a little earlier. So I think he felt the men's to try and fix that, and that he did, I believe, mate. And he was a big impact on anyway, your second half, mate. You actually got a fair bit of the pill yourself to help the side out. You're feeling pretty good with the bod now.
Yeah, it was good. As I said, Cheesy, he'd done a fantastic job to turn it over here. We thought, oh, geez, here we go, we're done now. But no, he did well to push forward and help that under. So, but myself, it was good to get a few touches in the second half, and I knew the fitness, you know, I'm sort of...
Pretty good for a 75-year-old, mate. You're looking bloody good. I'm loving your form. Anyway, congratulations. Go celebrate hard with the boys tonight. Well, over to you, Craig.
I've got the unfortunate losing captain in Aiden Coakley here today, right now. Very disappointing. I thought you guys had it. You owned that game for most of it.
Yeah, we felt like we were in control for a good part of the game. It's just these guys know how to get the job done when it counts. In the last 5 minutes, they really stepped it up, and credit to them. They're the champs for a reason.
Yeah, I must admit, I thought once you had the ball out here on the members' side wing and popped it out wide to Stocky, well, that was going to be the difference. I thought he'd pop that over and it'd be game over, but it's very disappointing. Mate, you'd have to say a positive season for Onkers?
Yeah, it was a good year. We had a few new faces, a few boys from the footy club come out and had a run, so it was good to get them involved. And yeah, we got pretty good depth, so yeah, it's positive.
And we want to give a shout out to your new sponsor and your new jerseys, which look fantastic.
Yeah, big shout out to Gabe. He's looked after us, so thanks a lot, mate.
Thank you for that.
Andy.
Mitch.
Where are you now, mate?
Relieved, pretty lucky. The fact that it was down to the last minute was pretty exciting.
Yeah, personally, Craig and I felt that the last 5 minutes was definitely in the Onkers side of things, and would have thought that when old Cheesy, I was just saying before, turned it over there, and just the uncharacteristic, he felt like he had to make amends for it, and did he so. He turned over and pushed forward, worked hard. And that's probably typifies what Western do. If you stuff up, you make up for it and help your side out.
Yeah, I feel like that was pretty much the whole day. There was a lot of fumbles throughout for us. Basically, I guess that's sort of our team commitment is that, you know, if you make a mistake, fix it.
And that I think he'll be on some shoulders later tonight, because maybe definitely was a big impact toward the end. What else? I felt like you had that strong contest with each other over the years, and it was a typical grand final, but they are just such a competitive beast, aren't they?
Yeah, I mean, obviously it shows. That's been four in a row that we've played against them. It shows that, you know, they're a solid quality unit, and yeah, the fact that it went down to that, I think we sort of pinched that one from them. So
well done, mate. Go celebrate hard, and now over to Craig.
Cheers, mate.
And thanks, Andy Mack, for finally finishing that up, mate. It's not all about you. Mitch,
how good's that, Bebo? How good is that?
No, congratulations. I'd have to say I reckon Onkers had more of the play and were probably, you know, had you guys measure. But where it counts, you guys were the difference was your finishing there at the end.
Yeah, I thought in that first half we had plenty of chances to be not 3 points down. And they missed their chances as well, but I think we just needed to settle and we didn't. Probably that first 15 minutes really put us on the back foot, and then it was a grind. I thought at half time we were in a good position even though we were down, but you've still got to play it. And they certainly they had a plan, and it was working pretty well. They've clogged the middle up on us really well, and we probably didn't work hard enough. We missed Riz and he's run through those lines, and that's what breaks up that zone-ish defence they play in the middle. But to have our chances to go in front, we missed three or four in a row there with poor decisions or shots from the line, and then... And then to go two down, and with a minute to go, the great man Jeffy Elson above, looking down on us, opens the net up, and Ant bangs one in, and we're in front at the end, and that's an amazing feeling.
I'd have to say, I reckon Nully to half time was struggling. Second half, he popped one under and kicked a few points, and I reckon he was second half probably best in the second half.
He's fairly new to the game, and as we know, it can take anywhere from 10 to 20 games to really pick up the skill, and he's under that. But his running ability is sensational, and he plays that wing role really well, and he's a very good footballer, so he's got that spatial awareness, and when guys are fit and they can run late in the half and it's 30 minutes rather than 25, it can be the difference. And our rotations were heavy, especially in that second half, but Noli's run and score was exceptional. You're right.
Excellent, mate. Congratulations. Enjoy it and have a couple on me.
Thank you, Craig.
We have Ian over here. Congratulations, mate. Well fought victory. Talk us through that second half. How did you feel like how you were going to get back into the game?
Yeah, it was pretty tough, really, because they were very hard on our defence coming out. It just seemed like it opened up a little bit in the middle portion of the game, and there was just nothing in it. We just kind of had to take our chances. There was some free kicks on both sides, and there was really no plan as such. It was just a case of taking your chances when they came.
Yep, I reckon both teams missed and got opportunities in that second half that were telling. So yourself personally had a very good second half. What do you felt like that you had to do to bring your side back into it again?
Yeah, I think it was just a case of getting possession and then trying to recycle it, because the game was kind of quite a fair bit in defence, and so when you receive the ball, it's pretty deep, so you just have to try and get the rest of the blokes that were coming up the ground, give them the ball, and then just get within scoring chances. And
yeah, I definitely thought that composure happened. You guys did take good shots in good spots. So anyone tuning in from back home at the moment, you got any shout-outs or anything?
Yeah, we'll say hello to everyone at home in Ireland. Yeah, we'll have to get them to watch the replay when it's awake time.
It's live streamed, so they're
in bed maybe.
Oh, it's 7 o'clock now.
Oh, they should be up and hopefully watching it over their breakfast.
Yes.
Yeah. Over a bit of porridge.
Yeah, and just thinking of Paulie's dad, Jeff. Yeah, we really did it for him. That helped us towards those last few minutes when the ball was tough to get.
Yeah, definitely. I totally agree. It was tough for little. There were a lot of hands on knees towards the last 5 minutes, and it was a great quality game. Hey, cheers for that. Awesome.
Harry from Shorty Recyclers. How good's that, mate?
Yeah, real good. Yep.
Yeah.
Full credit to the boys for that one.
Let's be honest, when you wear boots like that, you got to win.
You have to, yep.
I thought you were very good today, so a couple of good, nice point and some good defensive efforts.
Yep, thank you. Again, full credit to the boys who just took it to them all day. They took it to us. It was a great game all round, I reckon.
Got any horses running tomorrow or coming up soon?
A few weeks.
Yeah.
I'll let you know.
No worries, thanks, mate.
Just going to grab Cheesy because I want to talk through Cheesy. Cheesy, come over here, mate. Oh, Cheeseborg, come over here. We need to talk about not just the filthiest mile in the business, but I just want to talk about the turnover that happened here. Did you want to dig yourself a bit of a hole after that moment?
Well, the write-up I got through the week was I'm a bit of a big-time player, so I thought might as well make the game a bit harder for us. And
you did. So I said to Macca as well, I said he turned the footy over there and it was quite costly because they scored a point and that could have been the sealer. But in your credit, you've actually worked the whole pitch and gone, I need to now right my wrong. And you did. Big impact in the goal square, hands it over, the sack happens. Hey, so, how do you feel after that?
Pretty bloody happy, to be honest. Obviously pretty upset with myself. I was pretty down for a bit there, but got to dig deep last few minutes in the GF and do what you got to do.
Well played, mate. Cheers. Well done to you, and enjoy your night.
Thank you.
Have you had an interview yet, Jack?
Half time it is.
Come over here. How do you feel, mate? Give a shout out to the guys back home.
I am over the moon.
Yep.
I am over the moon.
How many flags is that for you, mate?
Four now.
Four P. Wow, yeah. That's congratulations, four mate. So run me through the second half as a kid nearly gets clotheslined by one of the safety fences, but talk me through like the second half. It was a pretty big arm wrestle. I feel like they won the last little bit, but then you guys just plucked a rabbit out of the hat, eh?
I think we definitely started on top in that second half. I think we finished the first half on top and then started the second half on top. And then they definitely got back in. It was just, like you said, back and forth, seesaw.
I'll probably have the class of yourself, Ant, Mitch, Les Burdett. You boys just probably had that little bit more polish on not turning it over at right times that just allowed you just to have that moment to have the good shots. But at the same token, mate, like, you know, they're still a quality opposition.
They were very, very good today. We weren't at our best, but we just grounded out. We had people going hard, 50-50s, turning 50-50s into 60-40s. And then, like you said, when we got
Let's get Tom's.
When he goes, you know, the players that we've got. When we've got the players that we got, 2.7 a minute to go, there's always that chance of a goal.
Well, they've got to sing the goat song, and I think they're going to sing it pretty loud and proud. Get in there, mate. No worries. All right.
Take the mic over and listen.
Yeah, why not? If they can, we'll get inside the roaming. The young man, 2-year-old Robbie.
Wraps up for settings today, you know, unless Craig's got someone else that he wants to have a chin wag to. I think thanks for tuning in, and hopefully next year the Mighty Taints can be playing and not commentating. Cheers for that.
Can you go to Ruby right back?
Blues beat Flinders and Eels by 1 point after extra time in the women's finals. A fantastic game of skill by both teams, so great showcase for the women's game. And just then, pretty much last kick of the game, Western just go to the top of Onkers with a late goal. So fantastic game from both teams. And again, a nice display of Gaelic, which we actually had live stream for the first time in the state. So a few thank yous with that to our commentators, Noobs and Bevo, some fantastic colour commentary. The link will be around. You have a look later on. It's pretty good fun. Dakes for pretty much organising everything in the state every year. Thank you, mate. Wouldn't be a sport without you. All the teams that played this year, fantastic season. The skill level is right up there. Fast Gaelic, so great is what we want to see. The committee, everyone helped put the day on today, so thank you all. Unfortunately, where there's a winner, there's a bit of a loser, so I'm just going to get Aiden Coakley up here to say a few words for behalf of the losing team. Sorry, mate, it's not, it's not hard.
Firstly, just wanted to say well done to Western Ireland. Yeah, you had the chance for a reason. It's four in the trot. It's bloody impressive. Thanks to the Dakes and the board for the season. It's always a good job. You always do a good job. And to our boys, just make sure you come back next year and go again. But, yeah, hard luck. Well done, Western Ireland.
Thanks, Aiden. Kind of a game without a referee, so I'd like to call Stephen Toasty Clay forward, if he's still around, to grab his medal. I did see him before. If he's gone ghosty, he can grab it later. There we go. Thank you, Toasty. Thank you, Toasty. And with every game, we have the best on ground, the final. This is a judge by the referee. And it goes to an Onkers player, Jamie Conlon.
All right, well, thank you, Western Ireland, for a really good game. It actually was a great game of Gaelic. I'd like to thank the committee and Toasty for putting on a good show today. And thanks to the Onkers boys, because I sat on the bench all year because I broke my leg. So I was just happy to be back playing and having a kick with the lads. So well done, Onkers, and well played again, Western Ireland. Thank you.
Thank you, Jamie. All right, now we go to Western Ireland, and I'll call the captain up, Andy Mack, to just say a few words. Where is he, Mack? Oh, he's changed sides. Mix it in. There you go.
Yeah, I'd just like to thank Dakes and the committee for setting everything up, and perfect day today. A bit warm, but we'll take that. And well done to Onkers again. You know, like year after year, we keep playing in the grand final. We're lucky to win this one, basically. That went down to the wire. So, yeah, it was good to get it up today. And, yeah, hopefully we can go again and keep coming next year.
And I'll get you to hang around and just announce the team, and we'll dish out some medals with you and Dakes.
I'll say Cheesy is the vice cap first. William Cheeseman Dutton, that is. Coach Mitch Portlock. Andy Groom, while he's on this side. Jack Andrews. Nolsey. Adzi. Birdie. Mika. Or Mark. Noonan. Jack. What do you want? Ant. Who else we got? Paul. Yeah, keep coming, guys. Come up. Has. Joel. Rob Koenig. Robert O'Gorman. Hask.
Mass. Connie. Louis.
Yes.
Oh, and John. Sorry, Alan.
You sure you got over there? Oh, they'll miss out then. That's good. And John, here, you do the honours. Andy MacDonald. Yeah. Andy, you might as well stay up here, and Matt will do the honours. He's the championship cup. Thank you for attending today. Just to let you know, we have our AGM and presentation night next Saturday night. AGM from 6 o'clock, presentation from 7:30. So team of the year, best player, all the best. At the Irish Club, we drink the cheap drinks as well. So get there and support the Irish Club and Gaelic in South Australia. Thank you.